Hey everyone, thank you for joining today for another Google Developers Live session on Google Drive. Today we're going to talk about how to use service accounts with Google Drive. For those who aren't familiar with service accounts, this is a special mode for OAuth 2 that is really designed to allow applications to act as themselves. Typically when we're using OAuth with the Drive API, we're building applications that are acting on behalf of a user and accessing the user's data, on their behalf and that requires a particular flow around what we call three-legged OAuth, where there's this exchange, a series of redirects, in order for the user to delegate that access to your application. With service accounts, we're basically removing the user from that equation and allowing the application to use its own credentials and act on data. In the case of Drive, there's really two use cases that this becomes very useful for. One is in cases where you actually just want to build an app that stores data in Drive, but it continues to own that data. It can still share files it creates in Drive with users. It can use some of the advanced features in the SDK, such as document conversion, OCR, image recognition, and goggles. But doing this all in the case in the context of owning the data itself and not acting on behalf of a user. There's a second use case, which is particularly important for Google Apps for Business customers, which is user impersonation. And we can use the service accounts functionality in OAuth to allow an application to act on behalf of users within a domain, but without involving them directly in the authorization. And we'll actually go through both of those with some samples. For those who are curious about how service accounts work, you can find information at developers.google.com/accounts/docs/OAuth2-service-account. I actually have the page up here. This page actually goes a lot into the particular protocol, the mechanism, which is basically it's an assertion profile that uses JOTs. You'll see those are JWT, pronounced JOT. It's basically a small bit of JSON. It's Base64 encoded, digitally signed, and then transmitted over. It's a lot simpler than a lot of the other assertion protocols that have been around for a while. Things like SAML is really simple, very lightweight, and easy to implement. Again, the information on here is really for building it from yourself. The good thing is most of our client libraries actually have this functionality built in. It's very easy to use. And for the demos that I'm going to do, I'm going to be using the Ruby client since that happens to be the one I work on. But again, you can find the same functionality, similar code in Java, Python, PHP, and I think most of the libraries now have this built in. So the first thing you really have to do when you're using service accounts is you have to create credentials for your application. I'm going to switch over to the APIs console. And here I actually already went through the steps of creating it. And you can see here we have a service account with a client ID, an email address. And this actually downloads a new public key, or a private key rather, when you create this. I'm actually just going to create another one here. It's not going to you can actually have as many of these as we want, but it's really simple. Create client ID, you select a service account, and create. That's going to generate a key pair. You can download this, and we'll get a PKCS12 file. You do need to make note of the secret. Right now, these are not password protected. Well, they are password protected, but just it's the same password for every file. So you do need to take care of protecting your private key once you get it. Also, you cannot download it again. If you do lose that file, you do need to regenerate it so that you have a new one for your application. But we created another one. I'm just going to use the first one that I had over here and switch over to our little sample application. For those who have gone through the quick starts before, this is basically a modified version of the quick starts that we've been showing off in some of the earlier Google Developer Live sessions. They're also up on the website. And I just went through that application and changed the OAuth mechanism to use service accounts. So there's a couple things I want to point out for how this works. These first couple lines up here are basically just the information that we need in order to have our app authorize itself. We have the service account ID. This is the email address that is generated for that service account. You'll notice if you go back over to the API console, we actually have two different client IDs. You have a client ID and an email address. Typically with OAuth 2, we're using the client ID in the various OAuth APIs to identify our client. In the case of the assertion profile with service accounts, we actually want to use the email address instead. So go over here, we have our key file. This is one that we just downloaded earlier. Again, just it's a PKCS12 file, and we also have the secret to unlock the private key. In this case, just not a secret. The rest of this actually follows very similar to how OAuth works in general. We see, we initialize a client. We have the API we want to discover, in this case, Google Drive. But instead of going through the redirects that we would normally do for OAuth, normal three-legged OAuth, we actually just load our key file, create our asserter with our service account ID, the scopes that we want, and our private key, and then we can just make an assertion. That is very similar to what would happen when in normal OAuth, where you would get a code from the user and you would exchange that for an access token. In this case, we're just exchanging the assertion for an access token that we can use in our application. Once we have that set up, we have an authorized client, and we can just do an upload as normal. So we can actually go and try this. And what we'll see here is everything worked fine. We uploaded the file, and we have the metadata. And here, the one thing I want to point out is the owning user for this file. And we can see here is our service account, our application basically is acting as a user, and it owns the content that we created. So we can use this, we can create as many files as we want up to our quota limits. One of the limitations, though, with this approach is there currently isn't a way where you can actually buy more storage quota for your service account. So there, in terms of practical usage, there are limits, but you can still do some very interesting things with service accounts. The other case I want to demo, and first I'm just going to switch over to here, is this mode of user impersonation. This is just our Google Apps control panel. We just have one of our test domains here, apps rocks. And underneath advanced tools, we'll see there's this link down here for manage third-party OAuth client access. You can click here. And I actually already created this earlier, but here is where we would do the delegation for, or basically to authorize our application to impersonate users on this domain. So basically what you do is you take the client ID. This is the actual client ID for the service account, not the email address. List the scopes, and then you authorize. Now what we can do is we can go back into this file, and now I'm just going to add my email address here. So when I authorize, instead of authorizing on behalf of the application, I want to authorize on behalf of a user for that domain. Can go back in, you can rerun this. And what we'll see is now the file is owned by me. So even though it's basically the same mechanism by virtue of the fact that I have at the domain level authorized this particular application to act on behalf of any of my users, I can now easily switch. This is really useful if you're building administrative tools, you're a domain administrator, you want to do auditing of docs usage or reporting, or just moving files between users in a programmatic way. Obviously, it can be very difficult to have lots of different users come and authorize your application. This just allows you as a privileged administrator to create applications that can do things across your domain very easily. If we were to try this and say, let's just, change this to my Google account, this will fail because this application isn't allowed to assert users on that account, on that domain, rather. So pretty easy to use. There's one other case for service accounts that I want to mention. It's not something that is currently supported, but this is App Engine robot accounts, which uses a functionality very similar to the service accounts that we just saw. But for various technical reasons, it is not yet fully supported with the Drive API. It is something that we're aware of and looking to fix. But you'll, you know, if you do want to use service account functionality on App Engine, you do need to use, particularly with the Drive API, you do need to do a service account created through our API's console, as opposed to using the built-in robot account functionality that comes with App Engine. Again, something we're aware of and looking to fix. But you know, there are workarounds for the time being. So that is service accounts. Again, you can find this functionality in most of our client libraries. It's generally pretty easy to use, particularly useful for domain administrators that want to be able to manage Google Drive on behalf of their users without having to build a full-fledged web application and have to go through the complexities of requiring each user to authorize themselves. So that is all for today. Look forward to seeing everyone on Thursday at our next session. I don't know if we have a topic yet, but we'll once we have that, we'll make sure that it is announced and available on developers.google.com/live. And you can also find us on Google Plus and Stack Overflow. Great. Thank you very much.